guys, Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I'm super excited to be showing you guys this new music video transition technique that I've been experimenting with. Now, I do this technique by using this free plugin which you can download. It's called Saber. I'll include a link to it below. And basically you install it into After Effects to get these glowing lines, these electric lines that you see in a lot of music videos. Now, I see a lot of people who use this effect to outline objects and other people, but I haven't really seen them used as transitions. Let's go ahead and jump into After Effects here. So the first thing you wanna do in After Effects is come down here to the bottom left, right click and say new solid. Now you're gonna wanna make sure that it's a white solid. And then you're gonna hit okay. The next thing you're gonna do is say new shape. So on this shape layer, we're gonna trace out how we want the transition to look. If you guys are interested, I do have a pack of 20 Saber transitions that you can use available on my website. I even have some free ones on there, so check it out. But basically, all you're gonna do is come up here to this pen tool while you're on the shape layer, and you're just gonna make like a little bit of a cutout shape like this. Something really small to kind of get started. And boom, you're gonna wanna make sure that the fill is black as well. Now let's come down here to our shape layer like this. Let's open up the content, shape one, path. Now this is gonna be our path on the first frame through the fourth frame. So we're just gonna make a keyframe right here in the very beginning on this first path. And we're just gonna come over here about four frames and we're gonna make another keyframe. Now this is just telling After Effects that we don't want this shape to change for these four frames. Now when we come to the next frame over, we're gonna make another keyframe and we're gonna come up here to our selection tool. We're gonna double click on this shape and you'll get all these points that you just made for this shape. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna drag these points out a little bit farther away like this. And this will start to kind of like reveal the footage underneath. So think of it like this, this white color box that we have going on in the background, that's gonna be the footage that we're transitioning away from. And what you see in this black area will be the footage that we're transitioning to. So you're just gonna keep dragging out these lines how you want them. You know, don't get too crazy with it on these first couple of frames here. We wanna go kind of gradually. We wanna have like maybe five or six of these shapes as we go. So now you'll see that we have our keyframe here. So now we're gonna come over another four frames to frame number nine. We're gonna make another keyframe, go to the next one over, and pretty much repeat the process. So we're just gonna keep dragging it out like this, keep making the transition gradually get bigger so that the clip underneath can be seen more and more. As you can see, it already made a keyframe. Go over one, two, three, one, two, three, four, and we're gonna make another keyframe. Do another one. Once again, click back into your shape, start dragging these points around like this. Bada bing, bada boom. Pretty cool effect. I'm actually surprised I don't see anybody really doing it this way or using the Saber plugin this way. Now we're coming up on our pretty much final frame here. We can see we barely got any white left, so our new footage layer is gonna be almost entirely filling the screen at this point. One, two, three, four. Right here, make another keyframe, and then we're gonna come over here and this will be our last keyframe that we need. Now you might notice that you click and drag around the shape like this, and you don't want that. You want to be able to control the individual points. So in order to do that, you're just gonna double click on that layer and boom, now we got our point selection back. And now we're gonna drag it over the entire screen like so. So now when we play it back, we kind of get this effect that is like this choppy cutout effect. So check it out. And this is gonna be what our transition looks like. So you'll notice there's no glowing line on it yet. There's no Saber plugin being used. So in order to apply this glowing line, all we have to do is come to our shape layer here, select it, come up here to layer, and come down here to auto trace. This will be preset to say current frame. And what you wanna do is change it to work area. This is telling After Effects that we don't want it to just trace that first frame. We want it to trace the entire movement of our transition. So we'll change that to work area. All this should be all set and ready to go, and we're gonna hit okay. Now it'll take some time, it'll auto trace it. What you're gonna do is drag this auto trace layer below your black shape like this. When you have your Saber plugin installed, you'll come over here to effects and presets. All the way at the bottom you'll see video copilot and Saber. So you're just gonna click and drag that Saber onto our auto trace layer. And we're gonna change our customized core from Saber to layer masks. This will get it to trace the shape we just made. And then we want our render settings, composite settings, from black to transparent like that, so we can still see the background. And now I'm just gonna pick a preset. For this specific example, I'm just gonna go with the default electric preset like this. So you can see we get like those glowing lines around the edges. So now let's try playing this back. So now we got that glowing line going around it. Now you might not notice it that much in this particular example. So let's really see what this looks like in Adobe Premiere Pro when used over top of footage as an actual transition. Hide your auto trace layer with the line on it. Now this is gonna be our actual transition right here. So we wanna render the line separately from the transition. So hide your glowing line like this. You're gonna come up to composite, add to render queue, go to output, and just change this to like, you know, whatever you want to call it. I'll call it transition example, and hit save, then we'll hit render. Boom, that's good to go. Let's come back to our timeline now, and basically from this point, what you got to do is turn off the white background and turn off the black shape as well. And all you're going to do is turn on your auto trace layer, so we just get this line. Now we need it to be transparent in the background for this to work, so we're going to hit toggle transparency grid right here. And now we're just going to render this line out with a transparent background. In order to do that, we do the same thing, composition, add to render queue. Now this time you render, you're going to change it from lossless to lossless with alpha under the output module, and then you're going to output it as, let's call this line example, and hit save, and we're gonna render it. You're gonna want to bring them now into Adobe Premiere Pro, so I'm just gonna highlight both of those files I just made in Adobe After Effects and drag them into my Premiere Pro timeline. Now you'll see that they're both separate. Just take the line that we rendered separately from our transition and place it on top of our transition right here. So we'll get something that looks like this. Now, what you need to do is basically figure out where you want the transition to start. I've decided I wanted to start it while he's looking out of this window, and it's gonna transition to this clip of him in the car. What you gotta do is take your two transitions and drag it over top of your first clip right here. Now this first clip has to be sitting above the clip that you're going to transition to, otherwise this won't work. So what you got to do now is basically cut this clip where the transition is going to start, and we're going to go over to our effects panel and look up an effect called track matte key. You're going to take that track matte key, drag it on to your footage layer that you're transitioning away from. So we're going to put it on this window layer of him right here. And now when we go over it, you know, nothing's happening yet. So what we gotta do is change the track matte key settings under your effect controls panel from none to whatever video layer the transition file is happening from, not the line layer. You wanna make sure that it's the transition layer, the black and white shapes. So that's happening on our video layer 3 right here. You can see as a transition example, video layer 3. So change it to video layer 3. And then we're going to change the composite from matte alpha to matte luma. And now we get this super dope effect. So when I play it back, it looks like that. Freaking sweet, dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is something I had to experiment with for a couple hours before I finally got it working. And if you guys don't want to spend the time and make transitions like this, I've already done that for you. Like I said before, I have 20 Saber transitions that you can use specifically designed for music video edits. Now you can get these transitions on my website, venturevisuals.com. I really want to put stuff out there that will help other music video editors and directors shoot and make better films. The Saber plugin is super trendy right now. I see a lot of people with run and gun videos, underground rap videos, using this plugin to make different effects. I just haven't seen it done in this way yet. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm still very new at making tutorials, so if you wouldn't mind, leave a comment below and let me know what kind of other tutorials you'd like me to make, or if you have any suggestions on how I can improve them, or just reach out to me on Instagram at Venture Visuals. I'd love to hear from you. I'm friendly. So, you know, let me know if this video helped you guys out, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.